Hello everybody, and in this video we'll be learning something about math.h. okay, so it is a C++ header file that allows you to get mathematical functions. So to get that in, all you do is you do hashtag include math.h, and there we go, we have included the C++ math header file. Now we can start using some of its functions. So first off, to begin with, we'll start with sqrt. Now I know sqrt sounds like something else, but trust me, it means square root. So yeah, anyways, to begin with, we'll create a basic program where it'll just say real quickly, ceil, enter a number, and the user will enter a number. Let's define a float float variable as a, and then we'll just say cin a, and we can do another cout saying the square root, or rather let's just say sqrt a. So what will happen is when I build and run this, so the square root function will just simply find the square root of the the number that we just enter. So let's say I enter 4 in this, I'll press enter, and it says 2, because in case you are not very good with math, 2 into 2 is 4. And similarly, when I use like 9, it'll say 3, because 3 into 3 is 9. So yeah, that's one function. Now getting on to other functions, let's do pow. Okay, it's like the sound that comes out when you punch someone, p-o-w, or you could make it stand for prisoner of war, but yeah, that is a bit of dark darker side of the pow command, or rather function. But anyways, jokes aside, let's just do that. A comma 2. Now what this will do is it will raise a to the power of 2. So which means that if I enter 2, it'll raise it to the power of 2, which will make it 4. Which is, in short, it just means that you're squaring the number. And if I was to do something like 3, it'll give 9. And you can do this with anything. You can do it 3, 5, 10, 1 million, anything. So let's real quick try it with 10. We'll try 10 raised to 10. It'll probably be out of range. Yep, it is out of range. E plus 10, but instead let's just try something like 3. So 10 raised to 3 is 1000, and that is what we should be getting over here, 10, and there we go, we have 1000. So that's about the pow command. Now let's have something a little bit more complex, and we'll begin with so let's do the fabs command. Fabs, I know even that is kind of a weird name, but yeah. So what this does is it converts a vector quantity into a scalar quantity. Now if you don't know what that is, let me show it to you. So I do fabs a. Now in physics you'll be using this a lot. It's called modulus, I guess, but whatever. Now we'll just say something like 10, it should return 10. And however, when I just build and run it again and I say minus 10, it will still return 10. So what it is, it just does is it converts the negative into positive and lets the positive remain positive. For logarithms, we have things like log and logs rather, and we have e log and whatnot. We have log 10. I won't be getting that into that because personally, even I don't know what that is. But yeah, I'll list all of them in the description below. But let's just try this, log a, and let me quit out of that and then build and run this. Oh, okay. Apparently, I am not sure what this is supposed to do. But you know what? We'll just ignore that. Now let's do something like sine. Sine is pretty self-explanatory. It is a trigonometric function. Let's build and run this real quick. And oh, that's why that. Oh, sorry. let's have log over there. Let's have a over there. We'll change log here. We'll make that log, and we can. I'll build and run that. Now it says enter a number. I'll say 10, and 2.30259 is the log result, you could say, of 10. Now, real quickly, let's change that to sine. So it's a trigonometric function. Let's build and run that. Sine of, let's say, 30, and that is whoa. Okay, yeah, this is because it does not show any numerals or fractions. Let's real quickly try 90, and that is 0.87 something, 89 something something. Let's real quickly change it to tan. You can do this for anything. You can do this for sine. You can do this for cos. You can do this for tan. I believe secant and cosecant are there, but I'm not sure. Let's just try that. No, they're not there. So yeah, you can, for example, if you wanted to do it for something like cosecant, so what you would do is you would do sine of a and just make it 1 divided by sine of a, and that will make it cosecant. In case you haven't done something like 10th grade, then you can just ignore what I'm saying right now. But anyways, so yeah, we have sine over here. Let's change that to tan, because I'm way better at solving equations that have tan. Okay, so let me just change that to 45, 1.6197. Okay, I believe this has to be an integer, and we will typecast this into an int. I didn't cover typecasting as of yet. We'll learn that in a future tutorial, but let's just do this for now. Of 45, tan of 45 is 1.61978. Yeah, so that's what that is. I'll be leaving a full list of commands for C++ math.h in the description bar thingy below, right below the like button, and you can refer to all of those. And yeah, they're pretty much self-explanatory. You can easily understand them. So yeah, thanks for watching. Bye.